So in this tutorial we are going to learn about NiFi and what is the processor which is used to read and write data to Hbase. So to demonstrate you, I have already installed Hbase on my machine and also I have created few tables. So people who don't know about Hbase, so basically to log into Hbase we use Hbase shell command. So I have typed Hbase shell and then I'm going to type list command to list all the tables. And then to see the description of the table, you are going to use describe command. And I have created environmental text account table. So I'm going to show you what is the column family name in this table. So as you can see, the column family which has been created here is named col, col in my case. So I will exit this shell and then we are going to go to NiFi screen. And here in the get file, I have configured to use environmental text account file. Okay, this is a sample file which I downloaded from the internet. Previously we were working on employee.csv file and this is a separate file which I have downloaded. So let me show you few records in this file. Let me clear the screen first. So this is the type of records which we have in this file. And as you know, why the update attribute is used, it is used to update the attributes of a flow file. So I'm using this update attribute processor to update input definition and output definition. And again I have created schema registry, and in the schema registry I have used environmental text account name to define the schema of the file which we are going to read. People who have watched my previous videos, they'll be already aware about these things. And then the next processor which I have used is that is called put Hbase record processor. So this processor is used to write to Hbase. So let's right click on this processor and click on view configuration. In the view configuration you see we have something called record reader. So in the record reader I have specified CSV reader. And in the Hbase client service I have created a new Hbase client. And if you are doing it for the first time, you will not see this client by default. Let me stop this service and let me show you. So whenever you log in, whenever you use this component for the first time, you are going to see only create new service. So you are going to click on create new service and then you can use Hbase client service. I have already done this and the client service which I am using is Hbase client. And also I have given it a name, Hbase client, followed with the IP address of the server. Now this, in this client we also need to specify additional Hbase related settings. So for that one you can follow this arrow link and click on go to. And here now we again back to the controller services where we have defined Hbase client. And if you go in the configuration, you will be seeing that I have specified Hadoop configuration file name, which is hbase-site.xml. So this file is going to be given to you by your Hbase administrator guy in the production system. So this hbase-site.xml, this contains information about Zookeeper and other stuff. Let me also show this file to you. So the content in this file is this. Okay, so this is something which is going to be understood by Hbase admin guys. You don't need to be worried about these things. Only thing which you need to know is that while configuring this Hbase client, you need to provide the information of hbase-site.xml file. And that's the only thing which you need to do here. No need to make changes in any other information. However, if you are using Kerberos authentication, then you need to provide Kerberos information. If you are not using that, then you don't need to provide any other information here. So then just click on OK and then I'm going to close this window Now let's go to let's right click on it, put Hbase record processor and click on configure again. And if you see in the table name, I have given environmental tax account. So this is the table name which I shown you in the beginning on the Hbase shell prompt. And inside that we had a column family name call. So in the column family name, I have given call as my column family name. Also, when you define a column family name in Hbase, there is something called row identifier as well. So here you also need to give information about row identifier. In the row identifier, you are going to give information about the row which is going to be uniquely identified. So these are the information which will be very easily understood by Hbase guy. So the only thing which you need to know here is these are some of the mandatory fields which you need to fill in order to get Hbase working. At the bottom, I have not made any changes. So the only thing which I have changed here is record reader, Hbase client service, table name, row identifier field name, and column family. Now click on apply. I think that's good enough. Now we should be able to start this processor and let's see how it works. So I'm going to start get file. And let me also stop this so I don't want to read the same file again and again. So now let's click on this queue and see what is the content which is inside this queue. Okay, as you can see, this is a very big file, around 50 records, and also there are many columns. So all this is going to be inserted into Hbase. Now I'm going to run update attribute processor. So update attribute processor is not going to make any changes. The only thing which it is going to do is it is going to update the attribute of a flow file. So in the attribute, if you see, input definition has been updated with environmental tax account. And in our schema registry, we have defined a schema against environmental tax account. So that's how put Hbase recorder knows that it is going to use CSV reader, and CSV reader knows how to read the content of a CSV reader. So let's run this processor now. And when I ran this processor, there are records which has been moved to success queue. Now let me click on list queue and let's see the content of the file. Okay, so all these records have successfully been moved to Hbase. Now to read the data, I'm going to run get Hbase. And if we just right click on this and configure, click on configure, we see we have defined Hbase client service as the same client name. And in the table name, I have provided the table name where we inserted the data. Now if I start this, as you can see, we are able to scan the data. Now let's click on list queue. And as you can see, we have three flow files, and let's see the content of the flow files. So as you can see, our data is here now. So guys, you might be wondering like why we have only one records in each of the files. Okay, the reason being is if you see our data, so in our data we have similar type of year name. So the way Hbase stores is Hbase treats this row number year as a unique, because in the, you know, while writing it, I had specified that our row number is going to be unique. Here you can see in the row identifier field, I have specified year as unique. So that's why whenever new data was being inserted using the same year name, it was actually creating a new version of the same data. So that's more about, you know, how Hbase behaves. But the thing which I wanted to explain to you, that using get Hbase and put Hbase, you are able to read and write data.